Hannah fans or any other colorists that are visiting this video. If you've seen my previous video of a skin tutorial I did, then you'll know that I said that I would record the rest of the coloring on this image, which was one of the images that I attempted to use for the tutorial. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to record this coloring this skin because my camera decided to stop recording halfway through. But if you want to color this image along with me, you can go look at my previous skin tutorial. I will put the link in the description. And you can apply the same method to this picture to get similar skin. This part we're going to be doing her hair. And I will show you what color we'll be doing. If you're from the Hannah group, you might have been able to partake in putting in suggestions for the hair, and I am excited to show which one I chose. Unfortunately, all of you that had ombre hairs with blue, I decided not to do that because I usually include blue in the hair, and then I feel like I have to do green water so it doesn't mesh too much, and I want to do blue water for this one, so we are avoiding blue hair. So in my previous video, I showed off Hannah's books, and she had four. There's this one, which is the first one. And then her second one is Enchanted Faces. I have the pocket size version, which is also available in full size. I'm not going to go into too much depth. I explained these a little bit in my previous video. You can watch that. And if you want to see flip-throughs, then you can just search up the name of the book, and there are tons of flip-throughs to find. Her third book was Sweet and Simple, and then we left off with Enchanted Halloween. And I do believe that I mentioned that we were expecting a new Christmas themed book, and here it is. Of course, I got it as soon as it was available on the Canadian Amazon. I've only been able to do one picture in it, but it was fun. I can't wait to do more. It's just like the Halloween book and the fact that it has two pages of each, so if you mess up or want to do a page in different colors, you can, which I think is a great option. So, the hair that we are going to be doing, I decided, would be Sunset Colors, and I'm sorry, I should have written down who suggested that one, but I didn't. So, I already went ahead and picked some colors and wrote them down in my little book. Now this is just a little flip notebook that I got at the dollar store, and I put all my color combinations. Here's my skin tones, and then here's some I got on YouTube, and these are all the Prismacolor Premier colors. I draw in my own little design, and then I'll do different color options, so if I need some inspiration or I'm not sure what color to use something, then I will go through here and I will look. You'll see that a lot of this is Hannah related, so I've got lots of lips, eyes, and hair. Lots of blank pages still. Got some stuff from Lost Ocean that I was working on. That was the Hannah Lynn image too I was working on there. So I've done a few different ombres of hair, and I will show them to you. First, I think I'll show you this blue one, which is on her. And this is Chelsea from Mermaids, Fairies, and Other Girls of Whimsy. And I really like how she turned out, except I wish I'd have done a little bit more light blue instead of the darker, but a lot of these are dark colors, so it worked for that image. Let's put that over here. Let's see, another one that I have done was my pink or my blue and purple one, and that was on Taya from Enchanted Faces. This is probably my favorite one so far. It was a struggle because there's lots of wide open spaces in her hair, and that really scares me, but I think I did justice to her. And the last one that I have tried is Ocean Rose from Sweet and Simple. And that was that bottom one there. So I always have references so I can see how the hair turned out. Also, while I have my books out, if you guys are interested, I also colored Apple Dumplin's skin from the Halloween book, so if you guys want a recorded color along with that one too, then let me know, because I'd be more than happy to do that. Alright, so the colors that I have chosen for this are all in Premiers, black grape, dioxazine purple hue, dark purple, scarlet lake, poppy red, cadmium orange, and yellowed orange. Now when I do ombre hairs, I will break this rule a few times, but I will usually have four darker colors, four lighter colors, and one transition tone, which in this case will be red. I find that it usually works out a lot better and will give the hair a lot more depth doing it that way, but sometimes eight colors is a lot to fit into strands of hair, so sometimes I'll just use six. Now, you'll have to forgive me because my coloring style for hair is to do it in sections so I don't get confused. Now, if you don't like coloring that way and you want to color all of it at once, then just do it your way, apply it to all of the hair, and you'll end up with the same result. So, what I'm going to do first, going to be tricky because I'm coloring in a box again. Let me zoom in a little bit here, maybe move this over. I'm using my cage to record. I don't have a stand for my phone. And hopefully this will record in landscape instead of portrait like the last video. Sorry, it's my candle there. This is gonna be tricky. Alright, so we're going to start here, and I'm going to, using very light pressure, I'm just going to color this whole patch of hair in. So the section I'm going to do is all the way up here. Oh, I'm sorry. This is using the Scarlet Lake. So I'm very lightly, I'm using circular motions because I don't want any lines in her hair. I'm going more for an anime style hair. If you want more realistic hair, then you could do flicking motions going up and down on the strands. If you want a really good tutorial on how to do that, I believe Dee Dee Willingham has some tutorials where she colors some Jasmine Beckett Griffith girls, and I do believe that Jackie Young has one, but she uses pen instead of pencil. Maybe she has some pencil ones too, I'm not sure. I'm going to break my rule, and I'm just going to do my base coat all the way down to where I want it to transition into the lighter colors. Now these little wisps, I find that it makes the hair look a little bit more realistic. If, say we're going to do red down to here, I would still do some orange and yellows up in here just to balance it out. I think I'm only going to do red down to about where this little sea monkey's hand is. shouldn't zoom in so close. That way you can actually see what I'm doing. Alright, so now I'm going to take... Let's see, this one. Here's the black grape. And I'm going to put that just at the top here. The top of each strand and bring it down just a little bit. This is actually the second color. I'm going to go over this again with some black to darken it up at her roots. I also like to come down with some of the darker colors on strands that go under other hair strands. Make sure I got everything in there. I think that looks okay. So now I'm going to switch to the black, and I don't want to go too dark with this. We're using very light pressure, just enough so we can see the color coming up. You don't want to press too hard because we've got lots of layers to do. Which is funny because I always say how much I hate layering, but I do it a lot. We're just going to go over where we put the black grape, but we're not going to go as far down. We're only going to cover it about, I don't know, I'm really bad at measurements, maybe a quarter inch. Just go with what you feel. You can always extend your black grape out a little bit if you go too close to it. So now I'm going to go to a medium pressure at the roots here and really darken them up. Also in these little places that we put our black grape at the darkest part, so the closest to where the hair is overlapping each other. I'm going to switch back to black grape. We're going to go over where we colored black, and we are going to, using medium pressure, bring it down and fade it out a little bit. So up here, we want to try to fit the first four colors. So as long as you can visualize space for the other two colors, then we should be okay. Who knows, we might even be able to fit five colors in here, I'm not sure. Honestly, when it comes to ombre hair, I mostly just wing it. It's kind of hard to explain, because it's like skin, every picture is different, you always have overlapping hair in different places, and hair is just one of those things where it's really hard to follow along with. I'm going to go back in and go in a little bit darker, close to where we put the darkest black. That looks okay. Next, we're going to switch to the dioxazine purple hue. And this one, I'm not going to bother going in with medium pressure. I'm just going to press with medium pressure right up to where we left off with the black grape. We're just going to do the same thing. We're going to go dark up to that black grape and then bring it down and slowly fade out, just wherever you feel. As Another nice thing about hair is you could almost do anything with it and it will still end up looking pretty good because it's hair, right? As long as it's not real hair. So I've done a few things to my real hair that did not look good, but I think we all have. Put in another layer. If you watched my previous video, you'll know that I use a colorless blending pencil to blend and burnish my pages. If you don't like using a blending pencil, then you can just go ahead and keep adding layers until you burnish it yourself or get it as smooth as you want, or you can use any other type of blending solvents or mediums, whatever your preferred method is. I'm going to switch back up to the dark purple and just put another layer in where it meets the dioxazine purple. Now the hardest part for me on this is I would usually, after I finish sections of hair, I'd usually go and I would burnish it right away to see what it looks like. But I'm going to hold off and I'm not going to do that because I want to get all of the hair colored and then see what it looks like. So that's going to be hard for me. I'm not very patient. Oh, I'm so sorry. That was black grape, not dark purple. Ugh. I'm just out of it today. Even if you did that with the dark purple, that's fine because we are going to go over all of it with the dark purple anyways, so. So I'm going to bring this dark purple out close to here because I want in here to be red. And same with up here and maybe this one too, but the rest, like these pieces that tuck under, I don't want any red in them. So I'm going to use medium pressure and just kind of color along the whole thing. Oh, we wanted red there, not here though. Or here. I do want to put just a touch of red on the tip of this tendril of hair. Again, as I said, it is just all preference. As long as you get your order of layers and have them coming down in that darkest to lightest order, then it doesn't really matter where it ends or begins, just as long as you have them in that order. Switch to that Scarlet Lake and just going to cover the tips and come up a little bit into the dark purple. Even come up a little bit further if you wanted, just to get a little bit of red in some of those other colors, which I probably will. So it won't show up too much, but it'll give them a little bit of a red tinge anyways. Now, at these tips here that I left for the red, I'm pressing fairly hard, not quite hard enough to burnish the paper, but hard enough to get a good layer of color in there because we're not really going to be going over that with any other colors. It's just going to be red. That's where it ends. I apologize for the quality of this video again. I'm, like I said last time, if you watched my previous video, and if you didn't, I am not a YouTuber. I was asked to do a few tutorials, and I figured, what the heck? Maybe eventually, if I get into enjoying it enough, then maybe I would get myself in a better position to record videos, but until then, it's just my camera and this dollar store storage cage that I use to set my phone on. Alright, so we're going to go back in with our dark purple, and we're just going to put one more layer close to where that red is, just to kind of blend it in a little bit. And this will help the dark purple transition into the red, because they are pretty, pretty far off colors. And now, yay, let's go through all of them again, starting with black. Again at the tips, and I am pressing fairly hard now. I want to get some good layered color in there, that way they blend nicer when we go back in. Put some black in these little spaces as well. Now you'll notice that I'm not doing highlights. I never do highlights with ombre hair because it's probably not impossible, but it's pretty hard. I have no idea how you would go about that. Somebody else may know, but I do not, so I just do solid hair colors, which is why I said I go for more of that anime hair color look. If I could put highlights in it, I would, but it's a little bit different doing ombre hair than just a single color hair, because you have all these colors, whereas if you're doing a single color of hair, or even, you know, this is two-tone hair, but you have your lightest in the middle. It's always going to be in the middle of a strand, whereas there's like four different colors in these strands of hair alone, so I'd have no idea how to put a highlight in there. If you come up with an idea on how to do that, please fill me in. Now we're just going to bring some black grape out of that black that we just laid down, just like we did before. And don't forget this little tendril of hair here. I keep forgetting about it, so I'm gonna layer it pretty good with some black grape there. Very lightly just darkening up these bits of red where they tuck under this, I guess it's a flower. Alright, and now we are moving on to the dioxazine purple hue. And just doing the same thing, bringing it out from where we put that black grape. I have to keep looking over at my color swatches to see which color I last used. Trying to explain this the best that I can. I'm really not a talker. I am more of one of those shy, quiet types. I like to observe other people and just listen to them talk instead, so part of why I don't think I'd ever get into the big YouTube thing. Also, I feel ridiculous talking to myself. I've been really busy, but I've also put this video off because my husband, or boyfriend, whatever you want to call him, we're not married, but I call him my husband, he's been home a lot lately, and I don't like recording videos when he's home because I feel ridiculous talking to myself. So, yeah, he's out at his mom's with our little dude. So I have a house to myself, I figured I'm not feeling the best right now, but nothing a little coloring can't fix, and I figured I might as well color this. So I went on the line there a little bit. It's okay, we can always erase it, and that's why it's always better to go lighter and work up your layers, because if I was pressing really hard and went out of the line, it would be really tricky to get rid of. Especially because the background is also going to be an ombre, technically, because it's going to start dark blue and gradually go up lighter as we get to the top of the water. Okay, I like that. Oh, I so want to burnish this. Okay, I'm going to bring some red up into these purples a little bit more, just so the transition between the red and the purple isn't so harsh. I'm not pressing very hard at all. I'm also going to put a little bit of red. This one I'm pressing hard. I want a little bit of red in this little fringe right there and here. Alright, so now what? Oh boy. Well, we're not going to start with black. So let's start with black grape. I want to keep black near the roots. So we'll put our black up here for a little bit so I don't grab it accidentally. And we are going to, hold on, let me sharpen this here. You know, a lot of people hate on electric sharpeners, saying that their pencils break. I don't know if my pencils just didn't get bumped around as much as other people's or not, but I use this EyePoint battery-powered sharpener, so I can take it anywhere with me, although I never color outside of my art room anyways, but it's a nice option. And I have never had a problem with it. So I highly recommend that if you can find it. So starting with this, we are going to start using a fairly firm pressure and blend it outwards, and we're just going to put this where the hair meets under this fringe, or close to her face here. We're going to fade it out rather quickly, because we don't want to bring this dark purple down too much, because we wanted to transition our red here. So we got to fit two more colors aside from this purple in here. I'm gonna go a little heavy where this strand comes, but I'm going to blend it out very quickly so we're not covering up too much space. Let's blend it down a little farther. As long as you're going with a really light pressure, your other color will sit on top of that really nicely. I'm also going to put some under here. Let's switch off to our dioxazine purple. We are just going to carry it on from that black grape. I want to keep it darker close to here because I imagine that would probably be shadowed. So this actually, it'll probably turn red right at the bottom here. I'm not too worried about that, but here, I want it to turn red fairly quickly, so I'm not going to bring this down too far. Some darker pressure up where the black grape is, sorry, and very light pressure closer to where that red is going to end. Oh, don't forget about this little piece of hair here. Okay, now we're switching to dark purple, and we're just going to keep doing it. Have you noticed a pattern? So we're going to bring that dark purple down here. So this is pretty well planned. My dark purple is going, covering just right where I left off with the red, so that's going to work out good, I think. That means we're going to have to fly through. I don't know why, but I always do more of the darker colors than I do the lighter colors. think, is planning on doing orange and yellow for her tail and bikini there. So those will be pretty light, so hopefully that'll balance out her hair. Very lightly, just creating a base for this red to go over to blend into the purple. Same with up here. I want that to end at red. Oh, and we totally forgot this. Okay, let's go back in. Well, we're gonna go back and color these all over again anyways, because layers, layers, layers. So let's go in with our black grape again, and this time I'm using a more firmer pressure. Blending down, we gradually soften up on the pressure. Okay, I didn't want to put black grape on this because it's coming out over top of where we already have the black grape. So we're going to switch to our, I'm going to mix these up. Okay. Dioxazine purple, and that is where we are going to put here. Which actually, it's a little noticeably lighter than the black grape. And again, the same thing, just a little bit more pressure. We're going to blend it down, softening up as we get to where we started with the dark purple. We just want to go over the top of where we started the dark purple just a little bit, just to blend the colors in together. A little bit under where this strand is, because that would be a shadow. It just shows, it pushes this hair behind, and it will bring this strand forward, because it'll be lighter. And we're going to switch back to our dark purple. I'm using light pressure for this. I'm just going to layer and layer, bringing it up into that dioxazine purple, and gradually blending it out to where we'll put that red. And down here, we're not using very much pressure at all, just enough to get a little bit of color on the paper. And if you're coloring straight out of the book, you know that this paper is pretty toothy. A lot of people have a problem with this paper, but I really love this. I have no problem, I actually prefer this paper, although I do prefer the paper in the Halloween book and possibly the Christmas book too, although Hannah swears that they're not different, I swear that they are. So the black doesn't seem to run. Maybe the paper's not different, maybe it's the ink. The black ink doesn't seem to run or smear as much when you're blending with a blending pencil. Maybe it's just me, maybe I'm crazy, I don't know. Maybe a little bit of both. I'm just going to blend this little strand out. I don't want to put too much dark purple in here. I want to keep it pretty light, so we're going to go over with the red. Same with here. I'm going to put just a little bit of dark purple as the base. Oh, that was strange. I almost had a little heart attack there. I thought my phone stopped recording. It beeped at me. And I look up and it says, well, that was quite a long video, let us stop it there and start another one. So, that's pretty cool. That never happened last time because I wasn't able to get that far in. I have a new phone now, so my son actually uses this phone. It's got a couple of his kid games on it, so that freed up so much more space rather than having all my apps on it. So now I should be able to record this whole thing with no problem, except I think I'm going to save that first video and this current one after we finish this side of her hair. Just to be on the safe side, because I might cry if this doesn't record properly. Okay, so we just finished up with the dark purple. Let's go in with our Scarlet Lake. So I'm going to start here up in this tendril, using a fairly heavy pressure at the bottom and lightening it up as we go into the purples. And same on this one because it's just going to end at red. back to a lighter pressure. We're just going to layer and layer to darken up the red, but we're going to keep our pressure light. We're going to go up into the purple here and also gradually fade the color of red down. We don't want to have too much red in this, I don't think. Let me refer back to my book of colors here. Yeah, I didn't leave too much red. Maybe we should have some more red in here. I'm not sure. I guess we'll just see how it goes. So again, we're using a light pressure and we're gradually fading it out. Now you'll notice when I'm starting on a new color, I'll always start like halfway up the other color. And that is how I find that you can blend it a bit better. And then I'll bring it up a little bit more, very lightly, just going over all these purples with this red. Quite literally, I'm going very lightly over all of the purples, about up to where we put the black grape. Just because we're like midway down her hair and it's still pretty dark, so... Oh, I pressed pretty dark there, I did not mean to. It's okay. So I think that's good. Now, of course, we're going to switch back to our dark purple, and we're just going to blend it into that red a little bit more. We're not going very far down onto where we put the red. We want to keep most of that red, but we just want to blend a little bit more where that red meets the purple. It took me a long time to get as good as I am at blending hair colors together. And I could probably still use some work on it, but I'm getting to the point where it's almost, the transition is almost barely noticeable. And the more you practice, really, the better you'll get. And I should say the more you experiment, too. Experimenting really helps. Alright. Again, we're going to go back in with that red and just bring it down a little bit. A little heavier pressure up at the purple here, fade it down again. Just want to have in here to be a little more red. Unfortunately, I think if you mix red and purple together, it makes brown, so I think I would rather have it more red than purple. Maybe not. I guess we will find out when we blend it. Hopefully it's okay, though. It looks okay without being blended, so usually when it's blended, it turns out even better, so let's just hope for that. I almost wish I'd have looked to see how long that other video was. Maybe it stops me at 20 minutes, I hope. I hope that was only 20 minutes, otherwise this might be a really long video. Alright, and now we are getting into our four lighter colors. So we're going to start with the poppy red, and we don't want too much of this. This is just to help us transition into that cadmium orange. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take this poppy red, and I'm going to go over all the red we just put down to lighten it up a little bit. I'm not going too far up into the purple, mind you. And as always, we're using a light pressure and just building up the layers. And I'm gonna bring this down here, fade it out, and that is actually about all we are going to do with that, I think. Of course, we're going back in and layering over top of it again anyways. So let's switch to our cadmium orange. And again, we're going to go over where we just put that poppy red. I'm going to add it in a little bit of the bottoms of some of these strands of hair here to lighten them up. Now I wonder if this piece of hair is connected here. I don't think so. I think that's background. Hold on. Let me just look up a picture here. What is she called? I think it's Bella's Sea Monkeys. I like working out of Hannah's first two books because she's always gotten colored versions up of them, or other people do see hers. Here's Jackie's version of Bella's Sea Monkeys. I don't think I've seen this up until now. It's actually really pretty. Jackie does some amazing work. Alright, let's see how Jackie did that. Yeah, I think she left that as the background. That looks right. Okay. So, I'm actually going to switch back to a poppy red here for a minute, and I'm going to tuck some in where this tendril comes out from behind the rest of the hair. I'm just going to fade that down because I want this to be the yellowed orange here. So I don't want to put too much poppy red in that. Alright, back to... Oh, I am missing one. Oh no, it's right here. I'm losing my mind. Okay, we're going to keep coloring with this, bring it down and fade it out as we get lower. Okay. See if I still have Jackie's picture pulled up here. I like looking at other people's pictures because this here could be a strand of hair or it could be the background. That's hair. I just like to see how they did it. Sometimes I don't like the way it looks how they did it, so I'll do it as hair or background depending on how I think it looks. Okay, I'm going quite dark with the cadmium orange up to this poppy red here. And I'm going to go back over all of this with a firmer pressure, I'd say maybe medium pressure. And medium pressure in under here and back behind here, blending it out. Let's see, what does our yellow orange look like? That might not be too bad. On my original sample of this hair color, I just put yellow-orange over the orange at the bottom to lighten it up, but I think in this picture, we'll actually put yellow-orange at the bottom. So, let's switch to our orange. I'm going to put... Oh, that one needs to be sharpened, too. A lot of the times when I'm coloring, I use a very dull pencil. And I've put some videos up on Instagram, just speed coloring videos, and I've actually had people notice that. I have had people ask me how I can color with such a dull pencil. And it's because I am afraid to sharpen my pencils because, this is a very expensive set of pencils, and I wouldn't have this if it weren't for my best friend. So, yeah, I'm scared to use them up. But it's funny, because these are like the only pencils I use now. It's bound to happen. Hopefully, by the time I use these up, I'll be in a better place to get myself some more. So I'm going to bring this orange to about here, I think. We're going to bring it farther down here. I'm going to go to about there. I'm using in very light pressure here. I'm just kind of trying to set myself a guide. That's some strange hair going on here. I don't know what's up with that. Let's see how Jackie did it. Yeah. Jackie used like three different hair colors, so hers kind of worked out. I don't know how we're going to do that. Maybe Let's bring our orange down on this strand and into this one. Just fade it out closer to the bottom there. Okay, we're gonna go up here and just lightly layer this up and darken up the orange. Same with under here. We're gonna fade it out as we get closer to the bottom. Darker at the top, lighter at the bottom. We're gonna go back in with our cadmium orange and just go over where we put it and over the orange just a little bit. Also going to darken it up around here and under here a little bit. Not this one, we're going to keep that orange. Also, just darken up here a little bit. And here, I think. So now, our last color at the end, but we still have a couple more layers to do. Oh my god, you guys can't even see this! I am so sorry. You'll be able to see when we do this one. It's basically the exact same as up here. We're doing it down here. This was our... From here to here was our poppy red. And then from here to about here was our cadmium orange. And then down to here was our orange. We got a little bit of poppy red in here. And then our cadmium orange, a little bit of orange. And we're just about to put in some yellowed orange. And, oh, I am so sorry. Hopefully you can tell where I put all the colors just by looking at this. I don't know where my mind is at right. I shouldn't be doing this today. Oh well. I am not giving up. Just bear with me, guys. We'll be doing something similar for this part here, so... You'll be able to see it there, and we skip all the dark colors that you did or were able to see, and we'll just be doing the lighter colors that you didn't see. Oh, I just feel so bad because I watch coloring videos where you can't see what they're doing on the camera, and it's like they're telling you what you're doing, and it's like I can't see what you're doing, so it just makes me mad. I mean, I know it's understandable. Most people actually have camera stands that are up higher than them. And mine kind of is. But if I look up, I can see what I'm recording. But I just didn't look up for a while. And I should have. I should be in the habit of that. It's because I'm comfortable knowing that the phone's not going to stop recording on me. Okay, anyways. There's our yellowed orange going up to about here. And we're going to use a little bit darker pressure just to darken up, well, kind of lighten up, I guess, this little area here that comes down, and this one too. And we're going to switch back to our orange and just go over again where that... Where that transition line is from the orange to the yellowed orange. Just slightly going over the rest of this just to give it a little bit more layer to blend out. Okay, and back to our yellowed orange because I missed just a little tiny spot here. Let's see if we can... Sorry, I'm going to move you guys here for a minute. Okay. So... Now you can kind of tell what I did over here, down here. We're going to start off with our... Oh, sorry. Ooh, this is Scarlet Red. I do not want that one. I want Poppy Red. There we go. Oh, it's going to be a little darker in that one spot. That's fine because it's shadowed anyways. So we're going to go darker up around her... By her elbow here and by the monkey's tail. We're just going to slightly go around that and we're going to immediately fade that out. Maybe go darker in here too, but not much because this is already going to be turning orange. Using some pretty firm pressure here and then fading it out as we go down. So that should be good for that. And then we're going to go back to our cadmium orange hue. And we are going to overlap the faded part of our poppy red. Actually, you can go up higher even. Kind of turn it a little bit more orangey, just a darker orange. And we're going to bring that down a little bit. About here, I think. Remember, light pressure, building up your color. We're gonna go back in with our poppy red and just go over that orange just a little bit. And then we're going to switch to orange, which I believe is this one. I have a bad habit of mixing my pencils up. So we're just going to go over the faded part of the cadmium orange. Just lightly, lightly going up. We're going to bring it down to, I think, about here. I'm using a darker pressure up near these little pieces here. And I'm fading it down as we get down here. Okay, I'm going to go back to our cadmium orange and do the same thing. Just blot it in a little bit where we... transition to the orange. Okay, and then yellow to orange. Which you can use a fairly firm pressure on because there is no other colors coming after this. Just enough pressure to get a nice layer down on the page that'll blend well if you're using a blending pencil. And I'm gonna go up here with it and lighten up some of these strands here. Switch back to our orange, and that's the last step here. We're just gonna go a little bit more over where we transitioned to the yellowed orange. I'm gonna put a little bit of orange in these little ones here, just at the very tops, fading down. I think that looks pretty good, but I'm still going to go back in with the poppy red and bring that down a little bit more. I'm using a fairly firm pressure because I noticed that this is looking really orangey. I don't want it to look that orangey. Let's be a little bit red back there because it's behind her. Actually, while we're doing this, let's move this in. Take some poppy red in here. Sorry about that. I guess I forgot to turn the sound off on my kid's phone. I'm just going to go in and just add a little bit more red in here. It's especially coming down on these oranges. Just lightly. Just wanna kind of try and make these two not look so separate. Alright, I'm going to stop this and go save these two videos, and then we'll start on the last section of her hair. Alright, so I got those two videos uploaded. The first one was 33 minutes, and the second one's almost 20 minutes, so we are going to hurry this along. Also, when it comes to the burnishing part, I am not going to record that entire thing. Well, I am, but not in full time. I'm going to speed that part up because really it's burnishing. It's not that hard. You just make sure you wipe off your pencil when you're going from a dark color into a lighter color, and I usually always pull from the dark, and maybe you should do it the other way. It doesn't really matter either way. You'll come up with somewhat of the same amount. If you go from dark to light, you're going to have more dark. If you go from light to dark, you're going to have more light. So that's pretty simple. Okay, so let's dive into this. We are going to start off with our black grape, just like we did before. And I hope you can keep up, because I'm going to color fast. I really don't want that video to be over an hour long. Just the skin alone was an hour. Well, on the other one, actually. Not even this one. This one probably took longer. This is full-sized. But I don't even want to know how long that other one took. Would have taken, I should say, because it didn't record. So, I'm just going to go in at her roots here a little darker, and then fade out. See, this little random strand of hair there. This little spot here, I'm going to darken it up a bit, just very lightly, so whatever color we put there will darken. I never do my base color of red. Crap. Well, let's go through and do that right now. So that would be the Scarlet Lake, and we will just go through and very lightly place it in all over up till, let's see, we went to about there last time. So we're going to go to about here this time. And maybe about here on this little strand of hair. So you're going to bring that up. And this up behind here is actually going to be more red. There we go. Just give a little, very light layer of red around this whole thing. Again, this is just a guideline, and it will also make the rest of the colors that we put down on the page appear a little bit more red, which is what we want. I mean, it's sunset tones, right? So now that we got that, switch to black, and I'm not going to put as many layers on this side, I don't think. I'm just going to use a little bit of a firmer pressure. If you are not very confident in your coloring, I don't suggest that you do that. I suggest that you pretty much rewatch this half of the hair for what to do on this side of the hair. I mean, it won't be exactly the same, but that way you'll know your, what is the word I'm looking for? The order. Jesus. That way you'll know the order of the layers. But you could probably still just achieve the same thing by following this side. Just, you could always just use lighter layers and just work them darker. Just by layering it more and more like I am here, because I don't want to do many layers, so I'm just going to make dark layers. Layers. Can't talk. Okay. So, we are completely done with the black, I think. I've been wrong before. We might not be. I'm not sure. Okay, now black grape, right? That's our next one. Let me check here. Yes. Okay. So now we are going to go in with our black grape, and we are going to go over the black and bring it down a bit. I'm going to go fairly dark here and under here with it. And then fade it out right away, because that's actually probably going to be a different color. So we'll go over that with another color. And same thing, just go over your black and drag it down a bit. There's really no method for how far I'm going down right now. I'm just kind of doing what I feel with it. A little bit in here. I'm using a light pressure and building it up. Actually, I should say medium pressure, but you should use a light pressure if you're not very confident in your coloring. This is just so I don't have to go over as many times. I prefer doing a lot of layers, but you can achieve the same look with just building your layers up like this instead of just switching back and forth. But that's very time consuming, and I'm trying to save time. So we got that. Oh my Atlanta. That was the black grape, not the dioxazine purple hue. All these are out of order. Jeebus. Okay, but now we're going to use this one. I'll attempt to watch this whole video when I'm making it, and I will try to edit things out. Now we are going in with our dioxazine color. And I'm just going to bring it down, I think, to about, let's bring it down all the way. This, we're going to bring it down and fade it out, because we're going to put a little bit of red there. Oh no, we're going to put a little bit of dark purple there. Same with here. The darker at the top, and then just fade it out when you get closer to the bottom of a strand. Same with here. And actually, let's put a little bit in here. And let's cover up that black grape just a little bit. Now, going in with the dark purple, I'm going to start at the bottoms here with a light pressure and building up our color. I'm going to put a little bit of dark purple at all the bottoms along this strand of hair here. And then bring some dark purple out here, going all the way in there. And then just a little bit in here. We're going to switch that to red pretty fast. But we're going to put some dark purple in here. It's going all the way along this, this hair tucks in under this strand and where it goes behind her cheek. Put a little bit on that strand and this one here. I actually really hope that's a strand of hair and not just water. Oh well, we'll make it a strand of hair anyways. Bring some dark purple up here. I want this to end in red, so we're going to fade it out about there. About here. And do that in dark purple. I'll go over that with a little bit of red to redden it up a little bit. Okay, I'm glad. Let's do a little bit of blending. Who cares if this video is a little long? It's just not looking like the other side, and I don't like it. Let's go back in with our black and just touch up our roots here. It's a good thing we did, because we missed this little top here. Well, I did. I missed that little top piece there. You might not have. Put a little bit of black in here, because we want to darken that very, very lightly. Very light black. I cannot stress that enough. Light on the black. It's a very dark color. Alright, now we're totally done with the black. So, now this one is black grape, not dioxazine purple. Yes, I got it right this time. And you're just going to darken that part up and up into the black. See, at this point, you should know what you're doing because it's just repetition. You just do the same thing over and over and over again. It's actually very boring. But so much fun at the same time. Yeah, I'm just kind of going over everything. We did a lot of black grape up here. Yes, I had to look at the pencil and see what color this was. Oh man, that's bad. Okay, a little bit of black grape down here and covering the black over here so it's not so black. And if you're wondering why I'm a little hyped up, it's because I got Timmy's, which is the American version of Dunkin' Donuts, and I am not sure about anywhere else, but it is amazing. And I actually don't drink coffee, so it's a white hot chocolate, but it's got a chai tea bag in it, which sounds really weird, and I was a little off-put at first, too, but I'm hooked. I am so hooked. That is my favorite drink. Alright, now the dioxazine purple, I'm going to put it in around here. Bring it up a little bit over the black grape. Bring it down in here. I honestly, at this point, I cannot even see where I've put the colors. I'm just kind of putting them wherever now. Let's go back in with our black grape. I'm going to go very lightly because I want to put some red in here because I notice on this side we have the red coming down. So really this probably should be red by now, but there's more hair on this side than this side, so maybe it's okay. Thing that I find with ombre hair is you can't really make it match up. You just can't. One side's going to look different. That's just how it is. And I have learned to accept that. I can try to change it a bit. So far, no luck. Okay. You're officially done with that color, too. Yay! Oh, sorry. Were we just using purple or the dioxazine purple? Oh, either way, let's go in with some dark purple. I think that's what I was using, but... Oh, I'm just... Got my cards everywhere, keep grabbing the wrong ones. That's okay. Still looks good. I might have messed up a couple times, but the best part about messing up is you learn how to fix it. And there's no such thing as you can't fix it. You can fix it. It is possible. You can do it. So we're gonna put some reds in a above where this strand of hair comes out here. And you can barely see it, but it's there. And I put a little bit of red in where this piece of hair tucks behind. A little bit of red up here. A little bit of red there. And a little bit of red up here. And then other than that, I'm just going to put some reds in all over the purple down here. And we're going to bring it out to about there, I think. Put some red here. So I'm going to go up on the purple quite a ways so I don't have to blend again with the purple. I'm just going to do straight up red and then into our next color. Again, darker at the top, to get it down as you get lighter. I think that looks pretty good. So I don't know if we're done with that red yet. But let's switch to our poppy red. And we don't want too much of this at all. So I'm simply going to put some poppy red just over where I have faded the scarlet red out onto. And then I'm going to immediately fade it off of that. So what I mean here is I went down to here with my scarlet red, so that's as far down as I'm going with my poppy red. But because I faded out with the scarlet red, you'll actually be able to see the poppy red, and it will appear as two different colors somewhat. They're really close in color, but should work out, I think. You know what? Let's go on with a little bit of dark purple. Let's darken the tops of this red a little bit. Just a little bit. Just very lightly. Just enough so you can see it. There, I like that. Okay. So our last one is poppy red. Let's blend with our Scarlet Lake red just a little bit, and then we're done with that one. So we are just going over that gap where we put our scarlet red in between the dark purple and the poppy red. So now we are done with the Scarlet Lake red. So we are on to cadmium orange hue. So I'm going to just put the cadmium orange in up to here on these ones, so they're just going to go up to the shoulder and where this tendril of hair is. I'm going to put a little bit at the top of this strand of hair that comes down. I'm not going to put some at the top of this one, but I'm going to put some on the corner where this one turns. I'm also going to put a little bit over the poppy red here. Lighten it up a little bit. See, make sure to fade it out on these spots. Let's go back in with our poppy red and just very slightly go over that orange. We don't want to go over too much because that is all the cadmium orange that we are putting on the page. Because I want to get down to the yellow in these spots here. Okay, so that should be it for the poppy red. Now orange, we are going to tuck some orange in here. Also in this one, and we're going to bring it down to about there, I think. About halfway down her finger. We're also going to put some orange in here. I'm going to bring it down to about here, I think. A little bit there. And again, you have one went out of the line just a little bit. Not making the same mistake as last time. So now you can see what I did over here, except I extended the colors a little bit further in order to fit all of them. So if you're really good at seeing space, like when I ended with my dark purple here, I knew that I had 5 more colors to go. So I was able to tell where those colors needed to be in order to get to the yellow. It does take practice to visualize that, but it's worth it because then you know you know, how much space you need and where to put your colors so you don't end up with too dark or too light. See, I think I actually did pretty good. I probably should have used a little bit more light. I probably should have switched colors up to here. This probably should have been the red. But, I don't know. I have this problem for some reason with using too much of the top dark colors. But that's okay. So we're just going to go over these areas a little bit more. We're going to come back in with our cadmium orange. I'm going to put a little bit here, just to darken that up. I'm going to come back over to this spot, meeting up to the orange and blending it out. And a little more here. And then we're done with that color. And then back to the orange, just put another little layer. Making sure to blend it out as we get closer to the bottom. And then our last color is our yellowed orange. And you can press fairly heavy with this one because it's our last color. And bring it up on that orange a little bit, lighten it up. So what are we at? 20 minutes. So 30 plus 20 is already 50, so we're at like an hour and 10 minutes. Hopefully the burnishing of the hair only takes me 20 minutes. If I speed that up by 5, it'll get done in about 4 minutes on the video. So that's actually pretty good. Not too bad at all. Now I'm pressing fairly dark here in the orange because I don't want to go back over with the orange. So I'm just going to use this pencil to blend them together. And that is our finished product minus the blending. So I'm going to pause this so I can turn my time lapse on and we will get to blending out this picture and then we'll be done the first part, technically, because we didn't get to record the skin. So the hair is the first part of this picture done. Thank you. so I just finished the burnishing, and my guesstimation was right. It took me a little over 20 minutes. And yes, I kept the sheet of paper here, just so we couldn't see the final result. So, without further ado, I think it turned out very beautiful. I'm actually quite in love with this ombre hair, and it is, I missed a spot. It is probably my favorite so far, I think. It's hard for me to choose a favorite. Of course I missed those little tendrils. Yes, my big pink brush. I like to remove the pencil dust from blending by pushing the paintbrush down like this, so you get an angle, and then flicking it like that, because then there's less chance that it's going to rub and leave marks on your page. So there's her hair all done and sunsetty. So for the next part of this, I want to say tutorial, but it's not really a tutorial. It kind of is, but it's more of a color along. Join me if you want. I guess it's both. It's a color along tutorial. But anyways, the next part will be, I think we'll just do a short one. We'll do the two monkeys and the fish. That's it. Yeah, it's the two monkeys and the fish. Depending on how long that takes, we might do her tail and her bikini and hair bow. And lips and eyes, of course. We'll see how it goes, though. So, expect that coming up soon. I don't know when I'll get around to it, but when I get to it, I guess you'll know. One other thing I meant to mention before I started coloring this was, for those of you who don't know, Hannah's coming out with another book, and she won't let us know what it is. It's top secret. It's supposed to be coming out around the 19th or 20th, so sometime this week, hopefully. Now, that's not written in stone. Sometimes life gets in the way and things have to change. But I, for one, am super excited to see what this book is going to look like, and I plan to sneak some cash out of my savings so I can get it without telling the husband. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this, and well, subscribe if you would like to follow along and see more of this color along. Also, if you're a Hannah fan and want to see other colored images like this, or have Hannah's books and want to show off your colored images, come join us over at Hannah Lynn's Whimsical Adult Coloring. I myself am an admin, along with my two favorite girls, Gabby and Danny. Out of the loop. They both end in E, and I'm just Skyee. Got two E's and an I. Gabby, Danny, and Skyee. Oh well. Anyways, I hope that you enjoyed this and learned something from it. And yeah, pop on over to the Hannah group and show it off if you color it. Alright. Bye guys.